that you say. Oh man, no way.
Lay down on it and everything will be alright.
But lay on it.
Oh,
but lay on it.
Oh, man, no
but lay down on it.
Save it for another night.
We're at the top of the evening to you. You're watching the Gagooch Show St. Patrick's Day special. Tonight, our special guests are Andy Julia and Jay Watkins. Watkins. Top of the morning to you. I'd have to have a little more corned beef and cabbage. And also, we have our video Gagooch Show video contest finalists. And now, your wonderful host and the only Irish person on the show, Jeannie O'Powers.
Hi.
And I'm Betty Gagooch.
I feel like I should throw a raw chicken at you because you sounded like Julia Child to do her transition.
Usually, will you tell me, Father? Tell me, can you tell me, Father?
I can tell you what. Stop it. Just stop it right now.
I'm in a very Irish. Everybody's.
We're all Irish today.
Everyone's Irish.
I got my green wig on
Day.
That's squeezing the brains out of my head. It's so tight.
And I have this derby on.
But yes, I am the only Irish person in the studio.
That's pretty funny. That's funny. So you've been away for 2 weeks.
I have been away. Did you miss me?
Yes, I did. Yes, I did.
Your guest last week wasn't mean to you?
No, she wasn't.
So you had you had a reprieve, is what you had.
She was very nice to me.
Well, I'm back.
And we had one guest.
So get out of my shot. I'm the only Irish person on St. Patrick's Day. Let's get back to me. This is my show.
Nicole, come back! Nancy, I love you!
Only in America do we dress like this. Do we dress like this for St. Patrick's Day? Because, you know, on Cinco de Mayo, do we dress like Mexicans? you don't see anybody dressing like Mexicans on Cinco de Mayo. I mean...
That is a great idea.
I think we should
make a video.
What,
yeah.
Put ponchos and sombreros and a leaf blower.
See. Fit about 30 of us in a truck.
Oh God! Hang out at 7-Eleven on Ocean Avenue.
I'm looking for work, senor. And I'll wear this.
You wear
with a mustache.
Get the mustache.
Si, senor. I'm Irish, senor.
Oh my God. So, yes, I haven't been here for 2 weeks. I had a Honda workshop at work for new car owners. We invite all our new car owners into Nardi Honda, and I give a big presentation, which is more like a big party. I feed everybody. I give away free stuff. I make people laugh. And
wow, you get free stuff? And
yes.
I should have bought a Honda.
You should have bought a Honda.
I didn't even get a T-shirt. I bought a Chevy. I didn't even get a T-shirt or a hat.
Oh, well, that's what happens when you buy a Chevy. Should have bought a Honda. Get free. Backpacks, you get a 250 service rewards card, you get to see me, get to eat for free, and it's a full catered buffet.
Wow.
Good stuff.
Oh yeah, good food?
Yeah, it is very good food, from Buenos Aires and Smithtown, so. We enjoy the workshop.
That's good, it sounds like fun.
It is a lot of fun.
You love to eat, though.
I love food. I love it so much, but I don't love Irish food.
No, well, I told Nancy I was going for Irish takeout.
And she said, beer?
She said, why can't you say beer distributor like everybody else?
Yes. You know, I was hoping we were going to just put a bottle of Powers whiskey right here on the table and do shots tonight.
Really? All right. Some good Irish whiskey.
Yeah, I forgot my flask. Darn. Plus, I don't like to share.
There aren't a lot of comedy shows, I think, tonight. I don't know if there's any comedy shows going on St. Paddy's Day.
Probably not, because they're all drunk.
Yeah.
All the comedians I know, at least. And rightfully so, they should be. So what have you been up to?
I have a lot of comedy shows coming up. And I'm working
that
with...
That you're in?
That I am in. I've been asked to be in. And
You're going to leave
April.
This outfit at home, right?
I'll wear the suit. Not the tie or anything.
I like the suit. Yeah. Suit's nice.
Thank you.
Even the shirt's nice.
Thanks. I mean, you know, I wear a suit when I perform now because I figure if I do have a bad set, then they'll say, at least you look nice.
He's leaving home the turtlenecks. I think it's great.
I love my turtlenecks. I'll be wearing my turtleneck when spring training, when baseball season starts.
Oh, God.
For George Steinbrenner, as a tribute to Steinbrenner. I'll wear my turtleneck.
Yankee fan, huh?
Yeah. Mm. What are you, Met fan?
I'm not really an anything fan.
You're not a baseball fan?
I don't really care. Who gives a crap?
I used to take my son when he was younger. Now it's too expensive. It is to go to a game.
It is very expensive.
It is. It used to be fun. I mean, you know, as a parent, taking your child to a game is great. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah, I mean, I was a big Mets fan growing up. I mean, in high school, I remember in ninth grade when the Mets won the World Series. That was huge. That was a big thing, you know, staying up late, watching it on TV, and having a Mets scrapbook. And
yeah.
As I got older, I was a bit of a Yankees fan. But, you know, kind of flip-flopped.
Oh, you did?
And now I just don't care.
But
kind of bores me.
It bores you?
It bores me. Unless the guy's really, if there's a good-looking player, and he's going to take his shirt off, then I'm going
to
watch.
I know. Nancy went to a Yankee game just to see Derek Jeter in person.
And, you know, frankly, I don't think Derek Jeter's that good-looking.
No?
Nah. He didn't do anything for me.
He didn't do it for you, huh?
No, he didn't.
Oh, man. He didn't do it for me either.
Put four on a baseball field.
Oh, the guy who plays Thor.
Oh, Chris Hemsworth? Oh, yeah. My goodness. Take his clothes off, put a bat in his hand. Oh, he probably already has a bat. I don't need a bat in his hand.
Boy, you might get disappointed.
I don't think so.
Nancy
I saw
loves
the size of his feet.
Oh. Nancy loves The Rock. She
oh,
loves The Rock.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't like him either.
No?
No. Not a fan. How's my fan club doing?
Oh, I don't know. We'll have to talk to Nancy to make that fan club. She'll make it for you.
Yeah, I think she's going to delete my fan club.
No. She finds it funny now.
Oh, does she?
Yeah.
I don't hear her. No. I don't see her posting on my wall about my fan club, Nancy. What are you doing? Everything else is on my wall, but not the Jeannie Naked Club.
Right now, Nancy's with a phone saying, I'm very busy, Jeannie. I'm too busy. I'm very busy. I do it all on the phone.
She's making avatars of herself.
Yeah. She's big on that, putting them in everybody's pictures now. But back to comedy. Mike Dillon, who we had the fundraiser for, is starting up a comedy show April 11th.
For Mike. I believe he's watching right now. Hey,
yeah.
Mike.
Hi, Mike. Shout out. That's why I brought up his name. We give a shout out to Mike. And his comedy show is to give back to everybody. So he invited first the 10 comics who performed at his fundraiser.
Okay.
Are the first comics eligible if you want to perform. And it's no admission and a 2-drink minimum.
And where's
at the Clarion Hotel in
Ronkonkoma. Oh, across from Applebee's?
Yes, right across from Applebee's in Ronkonkoma on Vets Highway. So no cover. I think that's great.
Yeah, where's that? When is that?
April 11th, Saturday night, 8 p.m.
Okay.
So, and I have to talk about, I went to this place, I went to a baby shower.
Ew.
Where the husbands hang out at the bar.
Oh, okay.
And it was a wonderful place, and Nancy said I should talk about this place, the Shandon Court in East Islip, on 115 East Main Street in East Islip. Shandon Court, they do catering, maybe they'll do a comedy show there. They have a lot going on.
I've never heard. Good?
The food was very good.
Okay.
The food was good. It was a nice place. I think we're having so much fun. We're going to, our video contest is going to be announced April 7th. We're going to announce the winner. So we're starting a countdown. So tonight we have condensed, the first four videos are condensed. Then we're going to bring up
the finalists.
Oh. We're down to 8 finalists. So we have 8 finalists.
How many entries do
That's
we
what
have?
We have, 8 entries.
Oh, we have 8 entries.
8 entries, 8 finalists. You can
I'm
vote.
I'm losing my wig here, people.
Does she look Irish? Text us. Let us know.
Do I look Irish or do I look more Asian with a green wig? My daughter said I look like a girl from that movie, Kick-Ass.
Yeah, you might look like her.
Yeah.
I think you maybe like...
But I think her wig was purple.
You look like if the Joker at Sailor Moon had a baby. You would be their offspring. But anyway, we're going to be showing the first four videos now. We're going to go to a clip of that. and it'll at the end of the video, it'll tell you how you can vote. So we want the winner is going to be from the viewers voting. Okay. So the viewers get to vote the winner.
I was what did they win?
We're not sure yet. I was going to raffle you off.
Ooh,
you win Genie Ballon.
You get
Ballon.
Time with me. How lucky.
Oh, you're so lucky.
You're probably getting beat up.
Yeah, wear body armor. That's what I was going to say. All right, we're going to go to this video, our finalists, contest finalist video, and then we'll be right back. You're watching The Gagoot Show on Madhouse TV.
Weirdo, I love shopping. That's what I do. I shop till I drop. I love to look good. Women love guys that look good, right? So check this out. I know this is a hard economical time, right? Not everybody got money. This is what you gotta do. I just hate seeing people in the mall walking around without a bag in their hand. Like, why did you even come to the mall? Just to hang out? This is what you do though, man. Do you got no bag in your hand and you wanna walk around the mall making like you got money? Just bring something to the mall that you already bought. It could be a store that ain't even in the mall. Like Blockbuster, Big Lots, internet stores, Amazon around the mall. Like, yeah, I got it. Crazy though. All right, y'all.
I'm in love, but I'm lazy, so won't you please come home? Oh, a honey pie, my position is tragic. Come and show me the magic of your Hollywood song. Will the wind that blew her boat across the sea kindly send her sailing back to me? Oh, a honey pie, you are driving me frantic. Sail across the Atlantic to be where you belong.
It's amazing how many laughs you can get on a few ounces of tequila. But truth be known, I'm one hopeless romantic. Emphasis on hopeless. I just can't get it right. Yeah, I was married, but I got divorced. We got tired of sleeping alone together. Our marriage was like a deck of cards. It started out with two hearts and a diamond, but it ended with a club and a spade.
Ralphie, you ready to eat? Let's go to that Italian joint.
Yeah, it sounds good. What's the name of the place?
That Italian joint.
No, I know, but I'm saying, like, where do you want to go? What's the name of the joint?
That Italian joint.
Well, I don't understand what you're saying. I'm asking you a simple question. What's the name of the place?
The one in Jersey, that Italian joint.
I don't understand what you're saying. I'm telling you that I want to go there. I love Italian food, but I'm asking you, what's the name of the place?
You know the place, that Italian joint.
I don't know what that is. How you doing?
do a live commercial. Hi, I'm Renee Marie. I'm the president of Language of Love Incorporated Foundation. I'm really happy to tell you that we're going to be doing a Language of Love telethon on March 29, 2015, from 2 p.m. to 8 p.m. Please look for the location on my my website, reneemarielanguageoflove.org. And once again, it's reneemarielanguageoflove.org. And the show will be on hosted on the Madhouse TV. It really is important for you to be aware of strokes and aphasia. Strokes is the third leading cause of death in America and the first leading cause of disability. And it really is something that plays no favoritism. And it also really comes when you're not expecting. Nobody expects to have a stroke and nobody expects to suffer from aphasia. And it really does play a huge, making a huge impact in your life and change your life in one split second. So we look forward to having everyone join us once again on March 29, 2015 from 2 p.m. to 8 p.m. And you can follow us on reneemarielanguageoflove.org. Once again, it's reneemarielanguageoflove.org. And we look forward to seeing you. God bless. We're going to...
Ready?
I like how Jay got a headache from listening to
one. And we're back!
The Jeannie Power Show with our guests.
And who
Julia.
Are
Hello. Hi.
And Jay El How do you say that?
It's El Payaso.
El Payaso Watkins.
Thank you. Yes.
That wasn't your birth name.
Actually, no. Jay is actually my middle name, to be honest with you.
It's Kareem in the Coffee, right?
Yes, Kareem in the Coffee. Right. Kareem in the Coffee. Right. Yep. Yes, that's one of my dad wanted to name me that because he's half Muslim and half Irish. Yeah, the cream in the coffee is the Irish part. But, you know. Yeah.
So he's an Irish jig.
I'm an Irish jig.
Irish jig.
Yeah. Irish jig for Allah. La, 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 la.
You're about to show us your dance. Did you want to do that?
Oh, you want the jig to do a jigaboo, a little Irish jig?
The Irish jigaboo dance. Yes, let's see it.
I gotta...
Oh,
this ought to be good.
I don't know.
Stay right there.
I don't really have much rhythm. It's just.
How do you have that? Your
back. Hey!
Oh,
hey!
It's the Carlton.
Hey!
It's fantastic.
Yes.
It's great. 2.5 hour ride for this.
Yeah. Thug life. Thug life. For real, for all my homies.
From Jersey.
Yeah. We're life.
Two Jersey stand-up comedians.
Yes.
That's what we are.
All right. Now, Andy.
Yes.
You've been a stand-up comedian, you said, all your life?
Yeah. Well, not. Yeah, well, I've been an idiot my entire life, and it just parlayed into doing stand-up
and
comedy, pretty much.
And you said your comedy career began when you stole a steamroller?
Yeah, I stole a steamroller from, like, right outside of my house and, like, destroyed half my neighborhood.
You were 14 years old?
Yep.
I would have loved to see that.
Steamroller? Yeah,
my dad was thrilled.
A steamroller?
Steamroller, dude.
This is Grand Theft Auto?
Yeah, something like, I was the...
Did you get a bill from the town?
No, we didn't. Actually, I didn't get ratted on. They like kind of threw it up in the air, like, "Oh, we don't know who did it."
Oh, the Italian guy didn't get ratted on. Ain't that something?
Yeah.
Just throw it up in the air.
They would have threw you under the steamroller.
Yeah, no, they wouldn't throw me under the steamroller. They threw me under the jail. Let's get it correct.
Well, yeah, that's true.
Under the jail. That's black true. Guy. 1, 2, 3. Stretch your out. Life at 7. Go figure.
Yeah.
Grand Theft Auto Fat Guy Edition. That's what it was.
Exactly.
I bet. Mm-hmm. This guy.
So go ahead.
You made a video that we're going to show later.
Right.
Because you're in the you're in our contest.
Yes.
You're finalists in the contest. You made a video. We're going to. Now, how did you first meet? How did you two guys meet?
Doing shows together.
Yeah.
We were like booked on the same shows, and we just wound up hitting it off, like, you know, just busting each other's chops, pretty much.
We have a third man in our group. We basically call ourselves a Rat Pack. Obviously, I'm Dean Martin. You know, I'm the sexiest one of them all.
Yeah, and Italian, too.
Yeah, and Italian. He's Sammy Davis Jr.
Yeah.
Because he has one good eye and he's black.
Right.
Yep. And then there's a guy, Chris Hayes. I like to call him Sir Spit a lot because, well, he talks like this. Like, he's like a white Mike Tyson. Like, everything is ludicrous. That's just him. But shout out to Chris Hayes. Yeah. I know he's watching this, maybe, if he's at work. If he has a job. I don't even know.
Yeah, he does.
Oh, he does?
So, yeah, I think so. But the three of us would get booked on shows constantly. And not knowing, you know what I mean? And we would just wind up talking and hanging out. We've been kicked out of green rooms for being too loud and busting each other's chops too much.
We actually scared some comics on a contest.
Yeah.
Because we were like gigging each other so much that they was like, oh my God, like, they don't even know each other and they're going at it like that. I'm going to get out of here before they say something to us.
Yeah.
I'm going to say something to you regardless. It don't matter.
They kind of keep it, when we're all booked on the same show, to kind of keep us separated.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So we don't get too loud as usual.
So you're nothing but trouble, basically.
Pretty much. Yeah.
So?
Nothing wrong with that.
Trouble is Mike.
I just found out that he goes and gets massages with hot rocks and bubble baths with salts.
So?
And what do you listen to, Enigma?
I listen to Enigma, Return to Innocence. I listen to a lot of that stuff. I listen to The Who. I like Who Are You. I listen to all kinds of stuff. I like Ellie Goulding and The Lights. I listen to all kinds of stuff.
Bubble bath and the salts.
Yes, yes. I don't smoke the salts, I thank God. But yes, the bath salts, baths are just amazing.
That's awesome.
I gotta beautify myself. I gotta preserve this sexy, as P. Diddy would say.
Right.
I think I am sad. You know what sad stands for? Sexy Abe, money sign dude. Gotta keep it clean for the peoples.
That's right.
That's what I am. Thug life.
Sexy dresses up like a 6-year-old. Ninja Turtle outfit.
I like Ninja Turtles. Whatever.
You're ridiculous.
Hey.
Whatever. And you walk around your house with a Comic-Con cup in your underwear.
they're shorts, dude.
No, they're underwear. Shorts. No, they're underwear.
Just because they don't wear them in the hood.
Andy, they're underwear.
They're shorts, dude. They're not
Andy,
underwear.
They have train tracks in the back. They're underwear.
Yeah, well, train tracks.
Because I like trains.
They got or
and
the bacon strip.
It was
a curvature. It was going down his leg. It was
the track.
He didn't have on his underwear his Depends that day, so right. You know he couldn't hold it in. That's what it was showing. Yeah,
because
yeah,
I'm
one
man.
Of them. He's
I'm
an old guy.
Hey, I get it.
I am very old.
It happens.
Whatever. He's just mad because I beautify myself. Nothing wrong with it. I feel sexy. He coming out here with the Guido haircut.
Right.
This ain't no Jersey Shore 30th year reunion. Fix your hair.
I can't. It grows like this. It just grows straight up in the air. So
Dragon Ball Z? Yeah, okay.
Dragon
okay.
Ball Z!
Okay.
All
right. Dragon Balls is right.
That's what happens when you're 40.
Almost 45.
Speaking of Dragon Balls, five kids.
Yes.
And a grandchild.
Yeah.
You don't look old enough to have a grandchild. How old are your kids?
21, 18, 16, 11, and 8.
Damn. Yeah.
I'm their blunkle.
Yeah.
Your blunkle.
Yeah, black uncle.
Black uncle.
They actually call me that. They actually call me that. They're
the
blunkle. Yeah, they seriously do.
Five. Are you done?
Yeah.
If he was to make a kid now, he got to mix it with water.
It would definitely be another female too. So I'm.
Oh yeah, you definitely, because you haven't mastered the other chromosome yet.
Yeah.
Like you just. Whatever.
Well, like you have. Or you put on Rascal Flatts and you tear up no matter what song it is. Talk about estrogen in my house.
Whatever.
You cry. During Rascal Flatts.
Not.
Go ahead.
You like country?
Tell the truth.
I do listen to country, so what? Listen,
tell them what I call you.
Do you stand there and put your arms out when Rascal Flatts is playing?
Why are you going to put me on blast like that, man?
Because it's the way it is, man.
You know what? You might get left here in Long Island.
Oh,
what's
a long
what's your favorite Rascal Flatts song? Sing it.
Oh,
please,
God,
no.
I'll not do it.
All right, hold on.
Tear fest.
Not necessarily a tear fest. I'll just sing the chorus. I miss Mayberry, sitting on my porch drinking ice cold cherry Coke, where everything is black and white. No.
I love country music, so.
I've just gotten into it, like the past year or some change.
Right.
But, you know, I mean, only other song that I liked before that was kind of country was Achy Breaky Heart.
Oh, God. Ooh.
Hey, I mean, it was a country twang. I liked it a little bit, minus him and those butt tight stonewashed jeans trying to shake it in the
mullet?
Yeah. Business in the front, party in the back. Yeah, I wasn't too big on the Joe Dirt hairstyle.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of him or his daughter.
He's the first black neck I've ever met.
Yes, I am
a
black neck.
You're a black neck?
That's right.
Black neck.
Black neck.
Yeah. Black redneck.
Black redneck.
Yes, I wear my Confederate flag proud.
Never mind.
That's not even a joke. That's for real. That's for real stuff right
now,
there.
Now, what do you think about Hootie? Hootie
and the Blow.
Blow.
I don't know anything about Blow, but I know about Hootie.
Hootie does country music now.
Warned about our language, right?
Yeah, we got warned about the language. Yeah,
but she can say Blow.
Yeah, she can say Blow.
The hostess chair.
Yeah, that's what it is. I got some if you want some.
No, I'm good.
Yeah, that part.
You're not that much of a redneck.
No, I'm still a little black. I'm still a little Negro. Not much.
Still got a little bit there.
You know. Do you have a gun rack in the back of your truck?
Oh, here we go.
You have a truck?
Oh yeah. Who's the NRA? You are the NRA.
That's also because I'm also a combat veteran. So I've gotten. Granted, I was always big into guns when I was a kid, but my grandfather kept us away from them. He didn't like them too much. But when Grandpa died, can't stop me now.
Bring out the weapons.
What you gonna do now? That's basically what happened. But I'm a life NRA member. Don't get me wrong, I support the cause, but I ain't too crazy like how these guys are radicals. Like,
so you were in the Army?
Yeah.
For how long?
10 years. Served Uncle Sam proud. Yep. So you're welcome.
Thank you so much for your service.
Yes, thank you.
No, I'm talking to the people out there because somebody would say, "Oh, yeah, right, he was in the Army. Okay, whatever. Pull up your credentials. I got mine."
What the hell just happened?
I don't even know.
I don't even know what he said.
I don't even know what I said.
I don't know.
That's a crazy part. Okay, I don't know what I said.
So far, he's a black neck.
Black neck.
He was in the Army.
Yes,
10 years.
I might
war veteran.
Yeah, I might honestly. And he makes fun of me for it, and Chris Hayes makes fun of me for it. I might be the whitest black guy you know.
Without a doubt.
Without a doubt. Like, I'm not, the stereotype that you people hear about, I said you people. The stereotype
what
that people.
What people? Who are you referring to?
You people.
What about me people?
I don't know, just people with green hair.
Anyway, before we get any further.
My vibrator just went off.
My vibrator, yeah.
And the first time.
It did nothing for me. It did nothing, as you can tell. It did nothing.
And the first time.
We're going to go to a video that you guys made called Face to Face with Race.
Right.
Which is a very popular video. We're going to go to that, and then we're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back. You're watching the Genie Powers Show.
Wow, got it right. TV. I didn't even have to correct him.
Face with Race with Annie Julia and Jay Watkins. POP, holding it down.
Jay, I want to thank you for being here.
My pleasure, Andy. How are you doing today?
I'm fine. How are you?
Can't complain.
With all the things going down in Ferguson, I figured I'd call you over here and talk to you.
Okay.
Got a couple questions for you.
Sure.
All right. How many stores have you looted?
What?
Do you like fat white women?
Sometimes.
I've gone hogging. I like it. Answer the question, yes or no. Do you like fat white women?
Yes.
I know it. I know it.
It's the black man's kryptonite.
Do you like grape soda?
I love grape soda.
Do you like chicken and watermelon?
Who doesn't like chicken and watermelon?
I don't know. I love it too.
You racist, stereotypical bastard.
All right. I want to apologize for slavery.
I don't think anybody in my family was actually in it, per se. But all right, I'll take your apology, I guess.
I don't think my family was here yet.
I want to apologize for your family coming over here from Italy with smallpox.
You gave it to us.
No, we had Ebola.
Oh, damn it. I don't know a lot about black people.
I don't know a lot about black people.
Why do you listen to gangster rap constantly?
I listen to country music.
Are you black?
Skin color, yes.
I don't think you are.
I'm like an Oreo. I got the black skin, but I got a white heart and soul, baby.
Have you ever raped anybody?
Do I look like Kobe?
No.
So there's my answer.
Kinda. Do you think all white people look alike?
Yes, you do.
Really?
Yes, and you guys like mayonnaise.
You don't smell like a Slim Jim.
I don't know what Slim Jims smell like.
A lot of black guys smell like Slim Jims. You don't smell like a Slim Jim.
So you've been walking around sniffing black guys?
Sometimes.
Sounds like a fantasy of yours.
No, they just smell like Slim Jims, dude.
Mm.
Puppy breath, I think.
Puppy breath?
I think.
What kind of puppy? It's got to be a pit bull.
Probably.
Yeah.
With a chain around its neck?
Oh, yes. Big chain.
I think we're doing big things with the race community.
Yes, we are. We're really going to set them back probably about another 400 years.
Probably.
Put them right back into slavery.
This is Face to Face with Andy Julia. And Jay Watkins. Thank you.
Mama, I love you.
Thank you. stretching under sedation or manipulation under anesthesia is a very gentle, very precise procedure to very slowly release any scar tissue that is formed as a result of a traumatic injury. Many people ask, how does this work? Will I get hurt? Will you stretch me too far? We only stretch the body part to its normal range of motion. After completing the post-MUA rehabilitation program, it's very common that our patients say to us, hey, I can play ball with my kid again. Hey, I can bowl again. Hey, I can enjoy hiking again. This is what makes it rewarding to us as practitioners.
Could switching to GEICO really save you 15% or more on car insurance? Do dogs chase cats?
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Yo, yo, what's up, y'all? It's just me, GMC, and the place to be, the greatest MC in history. There will never be an MC greater than me. And right about now, the only place for you to be is with the one and only Madhouse MC.
You are the best.
Show on St. Patrick's Day, because I'm the only Irish person here.
I'm gonna hit you with my shillelagh.
Your shillelagh?
Genial powers.
You're so little, your shillelagh is probably only this big.
Only a poor craftsman blames his tool.
Hey guys.
Hello.
You okay?
I'm great.
Let's see the shirt you Let's see the shirt you're wearing here.
Yeah, it's just, you know. It's
an Irish 12 inches black.
Yes. That's what she said. Mm-hmm. This is all for St. Patrick's Day.
That's what she said.
That's an awesome. Mm-hmm. She also said I gave her an STD, but that's a lie. Not this guy.
Mm-mm. No.
No, no, no. Only TDs I try to catch is touchdowns.
All right, we just saw that video face to face with Race.
Right.
How did that come about?
Like we do everything else. We were just sitting around at my house, kind of, you know, kidding around, talking about like maybe doing something, a video to get together, because we've done a few. But I said, yeah, dude, I got this idea to do this like interview show, because everything was going down in Ferguson and all the racial stuff. And of course, he's black, so it makes it easier.
Of course.
And
yes. I said, look, put him in a chokehold.
Let's just do, yes. We'll do it off the top of our heads. And it's going to be head-to-head. And he was like, well, what do you mean? Like, you know, we'll be sitting across from each other? I said, no, we're going to be head-to-head. I think it would be funnier. So we didn't know what each other was going to say, what our question was going to be, what the answer was going to be. And it wound up that was like, what do we did it once all the way through? We had to film Allison
yeah,
twice.
Well, yeah, see.
The girl in the beginning.
Yeah, the girl in the beginning. We had to film it a couple of times because she,
you say it.
Bless her heart. That's all I can say. Bless her heart. Because that day, it was just funny watching her because she was not necessarily inebriated. Just say that she had a little sauce in her system. How about
drunk.
That?
Yeah, so we had to film her twice.
Yeah.
But the video you see is actually just one run through.
Yeah.
So it came out great, I think.
I think it's a great concept.
It's fun.
And people who see it want to see more face-to-face videos.
We've actually done on my Facebook page. Yeah, I did face-to-face with the female race. And I'm trying to get a couple of other things going. As far as with the face-to-face idea?
We're going to probably end up doing face-to-face with the Muslim race.
Yeah, we're going to do that'll be fun. I got a couple of gay friends that we're going to do.
He won't admit it. He is the gay friend.
I can't do face-to-face
face with himself.
He can't do face-to-face with himself, but then come shot to his face. Oh, woman. Stop it. I apologize. Great. I didn't mean that. I didn't even say that out loud.
Edit it out on YouTube, probably.
Edit it out on YouTube.
Great job, Jack.
Hey, we need advertisers. We need the publicity.
Well, hopefully we get picked up by who's the one that's doing the Kim Kardashian tape?
Ray J?
Yeah, Ray J, Kanye. He's like,
Bruce Jenner's going to be doing an RJ hey, soon.
You mean
Ray J.
Belinda? Yeah.
Belinda Jenner.
Yeah, Belinda Jenner. Jenner.
Anyway, you guys do, you're stand-up comedians.
Right.
Yeah.
So now you opened, you toured actually with Gilbert Gottfried.
I did. I opened up a show for him in Pittman, New Jersey at a theater. It was huge. It was yeah. great. It was probably the biggest crowd I've done one for. So it was awesome. Yeah.
That must have been exciting.
It was. Gilbert Gottfried. It was cool because I grew up loving
you know,
it.
Yes.
Here we go. Horrible Imitations by Jay Watkins.
I know. That's right. This it looks is how
like
he always is, though.
He looks like he's on the toilet.
Isn't that how Gilbert looks, though? He's like...
Kind of. If he was you.
Bow-headed, black,
and you know, doing horrible imitations.
And doing horrible imitations.
Right.
You know. Do you do impressions in your act?
Only my family members, to be honest with you.
The Folgers theme pretty well.
Yeah, I had that in one of my bits was the Folgers commercial. Which is half true and half false about the joke, but people really say, "Wow, Jay, that Folgers thing was funny, and you are really not black." Sorry,
<It's> true.
What you want me to tell you? Hey,
very true.
I try.
So, what was the Android 2013 Top App Comic? What was that?
It was they ran a contest. It was voted on by Android users, and we got to put I think a 3-minute clip up. Of ourselves mm-hmm. doing stand-up, and it was a nationwide contest, and I won in 2013. But there was a guy who came in second, Kerry English, and he was awesome. I figured I was going to lose to him, but
yeah,
it wound up being I won, so it was really cool. A lot of exposure.
He paid
cool.
the voters. Then he knew he's Italian, so he's like, you know what?
They actually,
don't vote for me. Swim with the fishes.
The thing
with the fishes.
The thing that really sucked was I didn't care about the prize money that was involved. They promised me like a year's supply of coffee was a sponsor, and never came through with it.
Really?
Yeah, so, I mean, and that's all I drink is coffee.
Speaking of prize money, we're going to leave that part alone.
Oh, yeah.
That was a comedy festival that I was in.
Here we go.
In my old neighborhood.
Uh-oh.
I felt good. I didn't win it, don't get me wrong. It just felt like a soup sandwich from beginning to end. If you don't know soup sandwich, just Google military terms. You'll find out fast. And the winner of the contest is still asking the promoter for his prize money, right. Some almost 2 years after the fact.
Yeah.
Oh.
And the crazy part is some of the comics, they don't talk to me because they swear me and that guy are cousins. Just because two black guys are kind of buff and bald-headed don't make us cousins, okay? I'm just saying. But he does kind of look like me. Anyway, just want to throw that part out there.
I don't know where that came from either.
I don't know either. I just blurred out
that. How do you rein him in?
I usually let him go, and I'll videotape, and you know, we'll videotape stuff, or we'll just be walking around, and I'm like, that's just Jay, and I'll edit some stuff out. It's hard to do it in real life. You can't edit anything.
Nah.
It's rough.
Now, you said you start doing your own shows, Andy. You're doing your own comedy shows, and is Jay one of the comics that...
I'm bringing him in. We're going to do a Saturday night show at this bar called Sneakers in Folsom, New Jersey. It's a nice little place. Food's great. It's like this $10 buffet, and the guy's like a champion. He's won actual championships doing barbecue and slow cooking. He offers this $10 buffet that, I mean, it would choke a horse. And if you leave there hungry, there's something wrong with you. But, I mean, the food is awesome.
$10 buffet sounds great.
And it's a small club, a small little bar, but, I mean, we have a lot of fun there. We really do. We have different theme nights. We had a Pimpin' Ho night. We're going to do an 80s night. It's a nice place. Folsom, New Jersey. Check it out. You can go on Facebook. I whore everything out on Facebook. So.
And if you don't like, the buffet, there's a strip club right next to the place. Waste your money right there. Make it rain.
Is there really a strip club?
There's not.
As for me
club.
Though, as for me, I'm too cheap. I don't make it rain. I make it hail. I throw all kinds of quarters, dimes, and nickels. Just ring, ring.
That's him in the parking lot grabbing everybody and pulling them around a building and thugging. What are you doing, robbing them? Right? Yeah, thug life.
Thug life.
Thug life. Thug life.
Yes.
And then you give them change and they say, "Here comes that Jewish black guy."
So? Yes, yes, I am a Jewish black guy. Yes. Hey, it happens. People don't believe it until I let them know. Like,
that's
I really
true.
Am.
So far, you've told us you're like every nationality except for African American.
Hence why a lot of people say that I'm not black. I was actually told by somebody in my family that I was anti-black for a laugh. I said, "Oh, wow, thank you." Who knew? Ooh, thank you, uncle.
I have to tell you a joke after the show. This joke, though. I can't tell you.
Uh-oh, FCC won't let you be. That's an Eminem version right there. FCC, just saying.
So now you have all these children.
Yeah.
Are they any of them?
Actually, my girls are all hilarious. They bust my chops more than anybody.
Yeah, they do.
Are
constantly.
They all girls?
Yeah. I have all girls.
Yeah. What? Five girls.
Did
five
you
daughters.
Not read? It said five girls on there and one grandchild.
Oh, shoot.
Jeez.
No. Yeah, this five thing daughters. Is so tight.
Did you go to school
it's
in Brooklyn?
Wig.
Is
it's
that what
wig.
It was? Yeah. You went to that public school in Brooklyn that's failing? Is that what it was?
You.
Same school as me?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? You was on that short bus too?
I did.
What flavor were your windows? Mine was a cherry.
Great.
There you go.
You've been hiring them black guys, I can tell. Yeah, I'm top girl. You know you want it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Call me. I will.
Of course. Thug life. Give that thug loving. Anyway.
Five daughters. Yeah. Man, that's got to suck.
No, it actually doesn't. I haven't gotten myself a cup of coffee in like 20 years.
Oh, because they all bring it to you?
Spoiled rotten.
Wow.
Spoiled rotten. I swear to God, I
you blaze
them. You know, I've got two girls. They don't want to do anything for me.
Well, what did that, but they'll do it for your husband, though, right?
No.
Oh, well.
So, you know.
Well. But y'all give them options? Hmm? You gave them options? Go get me a coffee or just
no,
go outside and play.
No,
it's like,
go outside.
You're like, you know what, Mom?
You
screw
don't
you,
go
I'm
outside.
Out.
Mm. That's punishment.
Oh, yeah,
that's
right. These kids
punishment.
Are different.
Go outside and play with the dog.
Yeah.
But you know what? Give me a coffee or just get your cell phone and get out of my face. Selfie time! Snapchat!
That's me.
No, that is you.
Yeah. Italian men, though, Italian men, if they raise their daughters in a certain way, their daughters will take care of them forever. My uncle is 85, and he doesn't do anything. He, as a matter of fact, if my uncle was here right now, one of his daughters would say, we're going to break for a commercial.
Right.
He wouldn't even.
Such a smart uncle.
Oh, Segway. I love Segway. Awesome.
We're breaking for a commercial. We'll be right back with our great, wonderful guests. Jay Watkins and Andy Julia. You're watching The Gagoot Show on Madhouse TV.
Oh, God.
million women are victims of physical assault by an intimate partner each year. According to the National Coalition Against Domestic Violence, the majority of cases aren't reported to the police. Most people who are in an abusive relationship don't even know they're in one. The truth is, all abusive relationships boil down to one thing, control.
How do you like it? My new dress.
Are you out of your mind? You look like a prostitute. We're not going out with you dressed up like that in public.
But what am I supposed to wear?
Wear something decent. You can't wear that out in public. We're going to be late. Get back in there and pick a different outfit. I'm going to go run some errands. I'll be back in 30 minutes. Please be ready, okay?
Fine. I'll change. Fine.
Abuse is not always physical, leaving wounds that are visible on the outside. Emotional abuse is just as painful, only these wounds are hidden on the inside.
Are you out of your mind?
You're crazy. You look like a prostitute.
Know that abuse is abuse, no matter what the form.
Look at me.
Oh my God, what's wrong with me?
Physical abuse scars the body.
I just want him to love me.
But mental abuse scars the mind.
What you just saw was an example of a relationship that is emotionally abusive. Nobody has the right to tell you how to dress or how to act. If someone really cares for you, they won't tear you down. They will build you up.
The Genie Power Show with the once you go black, what?
You get put in a wheelchair Once you go black, your credit score goes down 200 points. So that perfect 800 that you that perfect 800 that you have is going to now be below average, 600 or lower.
That's a grade D right there.
Grade D. Hold on, before we even step out of here, you know what? I gotta fix this. I gotta thug you out a little bit, Ben.
Oh, you wanna thug me out?
Thug me out. You know, I mean, you gotta look Flavor Flav-ish.
Oh, all right.
Flavor Flav.
Don't ever do that again. Don't ever do that again.
I can't.
I'm not cool with
you. Just turn in your Italian man card now.
You're like Mr. Moneybags.
How many Italians can do it?
None. And you can't either.
Go straight to jail.
You're like the guy from Monopoly. Go to jail. Do not pass go. Do not collect $200.
Right to jail.
I'm going off to jail. Do they serve beer there?
Okay, Julia.
Yes.
They do. No, Julia Child.
Oh.
Not Andy Julia.
This happens to be my last name.
Andy Julia, yeah.
No, Julia Child.
Okay.
Top of the morning, Tasty.
Did this already register as the loudest show of the Goo Goo Show ever?
Probably has to be the loudest. Because I know I'm tone deaf.
We're all loud.
You're definitely tone deaf.
I'm loud, too.
And you hear the smacking of his man boobs smacking his stomach. That was loud, too. Sound like seals clapping. Maybe it's just me that caught it.
It's the same sound as the fat white girls you bang.
Oh, and?
Just saying.
I'm just saying. Extra cushion for the pushing.
Anyway.
Shade in the summer, heat in the winter. Go ahead.
So how many guns you got?
14.
14?
Yeah. It's
You're
a hobby.
Collector.
You know what? I am a collector. One of my next ones that I want to get actually is a Tommy gun. I'm actually into them.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
Oh, this is so cute. That's so cute. There's Situation 2037.
Situation.
Yeah, I like that six pack.
We don't have much time. Answer your question. Hurry up.
I got 14. And it's just a hobby of mine that I like. I mean, it's also like a little bit of a stress reliever. Not really a stress reliever, just I love the smell of brass.
Andy, is there something you would like to talk about?
You can find me on Facebook, me and Jay on Facebook.
Oh, you can say me and Jay, so I don't say nothing about you, huh?
Well, yeah.
You can call him the lovable fat guy.
Well, there you go.
That's his name.
And all your videos go to Facebook.
Everything goes on Facebook. I don't do anything on YouTube because I don't want to get lost. I put everything right on Facebook all the time, all the videos. It's just about everything I put up on Facebook. My daughter actually is our producer, our production company, Genocide.
Genocide Productions.
Yeah. So like, she does all the camera work and all the editing, all that stuff.
Oh, she does all that herself,
yeah.
She's awesome.
And what's POP at the end of that video? It's POP.
That's this idiot.
You ever? There's a video of some girl from Texas that really doesn't look like a girl. It happened like 3 years ago. She got locked up. She said, I couldn't drop that, man. I'm legally blind. Mama, I love you. POP, hold it down. Just look it up on YouTube.
All right.
So Jay ripped it off and said it for like, I don't know, 2 months straight.
Got all his kids saying it.
Yeah, all my kids are saying it. Like every time they have anything, I can see barely.
I'm just saying, do I care?
No.
Am I happy?
Yes.
Thank you.
All right.
I'm just saying.
What do you got going on?
Me? I have, this week I don't have any shows, but I'm working on our YouTube Gagoot Show channel. So subscribe to the Gagoot Show channel on YouTube. And also, if you're in East Islip, stop by the Shandon Court on 115 East Main Street in East Islip, and you may find me there. I may be taking at the bar or having dinner with my wife.
With some Irish takeout.
I'd have a tall English.
Just stop it. Stop, please.
And some corned beef.
And some corned beef
some
and cabbage.
Some Guinness.
If you don't mind.
Oh, wow. We're actually going to be doing videos for you guys for the Gagoot Show.
I've been wanting you to,
yeah. We're going to be doing some events in Philly. We're going to do Outfest. We're going to do Black Film Festival. What else are we doing?
We're doing my cousin's
Fringe.
We're doing my cousin's Coming Home Festival when he gets out of prison, too.
Right, we'll do that.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're doing a lot of stuff.
Yeah, you want to be the Gagoot Show reporters for Jersey.
We're going to hit. We actually, today, we just got a list of all the events that are going down in Philly and Atlantic City. Comic-Con's going to be Atlantic City. We're going to hit all those places.
Comic-Con.
People our way, and it'll be fun, and we'll send it to you. We'll be the official interview people for the Gagoot Show.
Yes.
That'll be great.
Me and this hammer here.
Ebony and Ivory.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And yellowy.
Yellowy.
And yellowy.
You're like a Mounds bar. You're not even like all chocolate.
No, I'm not. You know what? I am a Mounds bar.
It's false advertisement, really.
Actually, no, I'm not a Mounds bar. That's a Mounds bar. I'm an Almond Joy.
Yeah, you're
a Mounds
full nuts.
Bar.
Yeah. Full that's nuts. The reason why.
Yeah.
Almond Joys have nuts. Mounds don't.
You guys, worry. You should try like a duo act.
I don't know, man. I mean, this
head's too big. Can't get on stage with my fat ass. So.
Exactly. I can't fit on it. I gotta suck in.
Eddie, you done talking yet?
He won't sit still either. I think he's got ADD or something.
I do have Tourette's, one of them.
Something.
Tourette's.
One of them. It's like ADD's second cousin. I don't know. I didn't read that book, I guess. Whatever. Public school education. Don't judge me. All right?
Yeah.
Jeez. We have books that have my daddy's name in it. All right? Whatever. I'm lying.
Which daddy?
I got a good question right there. Which daddy? You're right.
Which
right.
daddy?
So how much you charge for a happy ending?
Oh, man. Oh. Massage parlor.
Oh, my God. Oh, he's out of the fan club.
Yeah, oh, you're out of the... You know about the fan club?
No, I don't know about the fan club.
People who imagine Jeannie Powers naked fan club.
Really?
Started it three weeks
he
ago.
He started yes. it.
Oh, you started it.
I started it, but then our guest, Robert Sibidanis, wants to be the president of the fan club.
Right.
So, yeah.
No.
And Nancy
no.
wouldn't talk to me
Maybe
for a
second.
You know who's going to be the president? Me. You know why? Because I'm black, like our real president, Barack Obama. Thank you very much. Booyah. Ballin'. Thug life.
To me, Barack Obama is just cleaning the place until the real president arrives.
Got a point. I came in tonight.
When you watch the repeat of this, wait till you see how gay you just came off. For real, that was all gay.
This is coming from the gayest man in America. This is the guy that willingly went to the Outfest and he's supposed to be straight.
I did. Was it Pride Fest last year?
He went in there wearing his red, white, and blue underwear, singing Barbie Girl, just...
You did, yes.
Who's acting like that?
I saw the
and
video.
Doing it very well.
I saw the video of you. I saw it for a year, so I learned your steps.
Right.
He just
Thank you very much.
For a happy ending.
Yeah, he did.
Oh my God.
Did it just hit you?
Really?
That's why I said he thinks he's in a massage parlor. You know, the Asian massage parlor. He talked to you like an Asian.
You just caught that?
Yeah, I caught it before too, but I was like, no. That's
Maybe she heard it wrong.
Yeah, I hope that I heard it wrong.
You thought, I mean, as clear as day. I can't even deny it. I'm sorry. I wish I could lie and say I didn't say it, but I'm on camera.
I hope she kicks your ass when we walk out of here.
She probably will.
With the heel of...
These are our
shoe.
New reporters, Jeannie.
Yeah. Hey.
Lucky you.
Just put me on punishment first. Spank me.
Wouldn't you like that?
Yes.
Yeah, I bet you would. It ain't gonna happen.
Damn.
No. You spank him.
No, I don't want to touch him.
Come on.
Fair enough, I hug him all the time. No.
Could you imagine those fingers touching my body? Those Vienna sausages fingers?
Leave him alone.
The imprints he would leave on my body?
Jay, do you have any upcoming gigs you want to talk
yeah,
about?
Yeah, I'm doing this, like I said, the Welcome Home Festival for my cousin when he got out of prison. For the 19th time, you know what I'm saying?
When's he coming?
For the 19th time.
Yeah, for the 19th time. He get out Thursday, you know what I'm saying? He's going to be tripping, you know what I mean? Like. She mad because he can't pay the $10 a week in child support. I mean, he hustling. You know what I'm saying? He got nothing to be worried about, some $10 a week. He got to buy himself some Jordans. Why is he worried about that? I'm just saying.
Why don't you have a party when he goes back in?
We do coming home parties and going away parties. We've been telling his kids for like the past 7 years, daddy's going back to college. They think daddy's a doctor. you want to call that a doctor? He's doing all kind of anal examinations. I'm just saying.
Andy, anything you would like to add to this?
Just you know, we do our monthly show. You can hit it, like I said, get us on Facebook, Andy Juliet.
Are
Jay
you on
Lockins.
Twitter?
I'm on Twitter. I'm on Instagram.
Do it all.
All of it. We do a monthly show at Sneakers Bar in Folsom. April Shank is the manager there. You can hit her up, hit the bar up. Mainly, just go to my Facebook page. You can find everything.
Just go to his Facebook page.
Yep.
Andy Julia in New Jersey.
That's right.
And Jay Watkins.
In space. In
space.
From Compton. Westside. Tupac, I love you.
Knock it off.
Same thing. Stop it.
I want to thank you both for coming.
Thank you.
As always, I love you as my co-host, but Nicole, I miss you.
Stop it. I will be on LI News Radio 103.9 FM this Friday and every Friday with my Hollywood Hit List Entertainment Report at 6:48, 7:48, and 8:48 FM. So tune in to me.
Yeah, FM to you too.
Is that field manager?
You've been watching The Gagoot Show, our Irish special. So thank you very much. Have a wonderful evening. Don't drink and drive. You'll spill that booze all over your clothes.
Drive responsibly. Have a drink for me. Have a few drinks for me.
When
after
you get
this
home.
Show.
See you.
My God.
Love you.
See you. Say wave to the camera.
See you.
Wave to your daughters. They're
Bye.
Watching.
We'll come home later.
No, we're not. We're going to a strip club.
All right. Thank you. Bye. And we're done.